Texas, starring Beverly McKenzie.
Just long enough for our special passenger to debark, and we'll take off almost immediately thereafter. On behalf of Texair, I'd like to apologize for the inconvenience this delay may cause. And now, if you'll fasten your seatbelts, we'll be turning back in just a moment. Thank you.
Excuse me, miss, but the flight's returning to Houston. I'm quite anxious to arrive in Bay City, perhaps another airline.
But, Mrs. Carrington, I thought you knew.
Thought I knew what?
But you were the reason we were asked to turn the plane back.
For me?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, did they say if anything was wrong?
No, ma'am. Just that you were to deplane at Houston International. Well, that's all I know.
You mean you did it? You got the president of Texair to turn that plane back for you?
Why, Terry Decker, if I didn't know better, I'd actually think you doubted what
happened. Boss, I sent Jack out to meet that plane as soon as you told me to get Mr. Craighead on the phone.
Good girl. He knows which flight?
Texair 901, and he'll be at the gate by the time the plane arrives in Houston.
Which will be in about 10 minutes. Good job, Terry. Good job.
Thank you.
Next, once Jack picks her up, where do you want him to take her? To the World Building?
No. No, I don't want to meet her in an office.
Okay, but then where?
Tell him to bring her out to the yacht. I'll have a steward prepare us a breakfast.
That's perfect. Of course.
And Terry, if you listen to me, I may not be back for a while. You understand?
Do I understand? Look, don't you worry about a thing, okay? I'll parcel all your work out to those junior execs. There's not one of them who's not hungry for more power, and you know it.
We'll let them earn their keep for a change, huh? I'll let you know for sure later. Well, that's it then.
Except for one thing.
What's that?
I just want you to know that I have my fingers crossed so tightly for you.
Just uncross them long enough to get Jack on the phone and tell him to bring Iris here, hmm? I've got a few things to take care of before she arrives. Goodbye, Terry. This is where I saw you for the first time, Iris. On this very yacht. This is where we met.
Well, I ask him to come in.
But I don't believe I remember.
Hi there, pretty lady. I'm Alex Freeler of Texas. And you, of course, are unforgettable.
Of course. It's all right.
It was our last night. We had rooms in a small hotel on the coast. Iris has had a terrace. We had dinner overlooking the sea. How could I have done that? How could I ever have left her? I should have stayed. I should have told her the truth. And yet, I couldn't then. But perhaps now, I can make amends. Nothing ventured, nothing gained. Full speed ahead. Oren, I want to see you and Edward immediately. I want you to make preparations for a very special guest.
I'm Jack, Mr. Wheeler's chauffeur. Mr. Wheeler sends his compliments and requests that you join him for breakfast on his yacht.
Mr. Wheeler requests? And did he request that the plane be turned back too?
I'm afraid you'd have to ask Mr. Wheeler that yourself, ma'am.
Yes, of course, but I'm asking you.
Well, let me say that if Mr. Wheeler had wanted that plane turned back, it would have turned back. However, if you follow me, I'll be taking you to him and you can ask him yourself. Miss Carrington, if you're ready to go.
How can I go with you? My luggage.
Your luggage appears to be here.
Hey, Harry, you got that passenger's luggage unloaded from flight 901 yet? Pilot wants to know if he can get himself clear for takeoff.
Mission accomplished.
Car's right outside. Miss Carrington, shall we go? Mr. Wheeler will be waiting.
Yes, let's go.
Miss Carrington?
Yes.
May I offer you a glass of champagne, Mr. Wheeler's favorite?
Thank you, Jack, but no, I don't think so.
Terry? Jack? Yes, I have Miss Carrington with me now. Right, the plane took off as soon as the baggage was removed, and we're on the way to the yacht club right now, unless there's been some sort of change in plans. I didn't think so. Right, it won't be long now. Bye.
Miss Carrington?
Excuse me, Jack, but you did say Mr. Wheeler asked you to take me to his yacht. Is that correct?
Yes, ma'am. Mr. Wheeler's waiting for us right now at the Houston Yacht Club. And if I may say so, Miss Carrington, I believe he's most anxious to see you.
Anxious. He can't be half as anxious as I am right now.
No! Ryan, we did it! We did it! We pulled it off! Iris is in the limousine on her way to the yacht. And the rest is in Alex's hands now.
Oh, it must be the Irish in me. All this romance really gets to me, lass. Hey, but you yelling like that, huh? What's your excuse?
Oh, I don't know. I kind of love Alex, and I just like to see people I care about finally get what they deserve. Alex has waited much too long for his happiness. Don't you think it's due him?
Me? Well, I just like to see people get what they deserve, period.
You're thinking about Sheikh Zaidi's murder, aren't you? You look so grim. Come to think of it, so did Clipper when I interrupted you two. Were you having some kind of argument?
That guy knows something. Something he isn't telling.
Clipper? Clipper told Alex everything he knew.
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
Oh. I don't know about you, Terry, but something about this Curtis is really bad news to me. I just can't quite put my finger on it. But he's lying about something, about that conversation he overheard. I don't know, I just can't quite get to it.
The look on your face. I just can't believe you're talking about the Clipper Curtis I know. He isn't keeping anything from Alex.
You love him, don't you?
Very much.
Is that what makes you believe he'd never lie to Alex? The fact that you believe in him?
If that'd be enough for me, yes. But he owes Alex, too. After Clipper was hurt in that last game for the Oilers, I asked Alex to help him out. So Alex offered him a job managing the top of the world. The salary's unbeatable. The place is full of the high rollers that Clipper loves to be around. And Clipper does a good job, too. Everybody thinks he owns it. That's Alex's doing, too.
So Alex did him a good turn. Well, you'd think he'd be loyal, that he'd tell Alex everything important that he'd heard of right away, but he didn't.
He wasn't really sure if what he'd overheard was even important.
Do you think so? Really?
Yes, really. Why would he lie to me? Clipper loves me.
I don't think Curtis has ever loved anyone in his whole life. Certainly not someone as loving and as good as you are.
Well, I'd bet on him.
Oh, would you? Well, don't invest too much of yourself in him, though. Because by the time the FBI gets through with him, you may not be seeing him for a long, long time.
Clipper hasn't done anything wrong.
I hope not, for your sake.
Look, is there anything else you wanted to ask me, Mr.
Nope.
Connor? Fine. Because I don't think I like the turn this conversation is taking.
Suit yourself. But if you could just tell me how I might place an international phone call from here, huh?
Ask for the international operator.
Yes, international operator. I'd like to place a call to Tangier, to the palace of Sheikh Zaidi, person to person to Princess Yasmin. Yes, I'll hold. Thank you. About to land in Houston, sir. Better fasten your safety belt.
I have that, Ryan. Holy Quran has held me fast. I would have gone too far. But you refer to a more worldly safety device.
Stand back!
What do you mean? Get out of my way.
Hey. Just a minute, friend. I'm not letting anyone near Sheikh Zaidi until I check out who they are and whether or not they're armed. Now, turn around.
I'll tell you who I am. I'm Mike Marshall, president of Marshall Oil. The plane you flew in on belongs to me. I'm the one who arranged for Zaidi to fly over here. Now, just who the hell are you?
Ryan, the doctors are in with Father now. Will you wait with me? Ryan. I'm so frightened for him.
Hey, don't be. They say this Dr. Cook's the best in the business.
I hope so.
I mean, why were you so quick to reassure Yasmin? Sir, she's got to realize she
She's got to be prepared.
Ryan, indulge an old man. She's my youngest, my baby. Everything about her shines with innocence. I do not want to be the one to bring anxiety and sorrow to her. Do you understand?
I just don't think it's fair to her, that's all. What if something happens to you? What's she gonna do then?
She will turn to you. It will come to her as naturally as breathing. Promise me, if that does happen, that you will look after her, guard her, and return her safely to her family in Tangier.
Of course I will.
Perhaps it is a good sign that Dr. Cook has not returned. It is an indication that she's there to lose.
Would you please repeat that, operator? The Princess Yasmin is no longer at the palace? I'd like you to try another number for me, please.
Is that Connor guy still there?
Maybe. He had to make a phone call.
I hope it's a short one.
Why?
I don't like him. When you came in this morning, I was just about to break his nose.
That might not be too easy.
You may be right. It looks tough. And all that State Department business is just a front. The guy was the security chief of that Arab sheik. I figure he must be CIA or something like that.
He said something about the FBI coming around to talk to you.
Well, that's fine with me. I'll tell him what I told Alex. I got nothing to hide.
Are you sure?
What do you mean, am I sure? Of course I'm sure.
I mean, honey, what you told Alex, are you sure that's all there is to tell?
Okay, just for argument's sake, let's say I am keeping something back. What side would you be on, Terry? Why would you come down?
Clipper, there's only one side. The side that wants whoever killed that old man punished. And you and Alex and I are on that side. Aren't we?
Look, honey, that's the right side. I know that. But there's no money there. And me, I don't care about the reward of knowing I did the right thing. And I'm not gonna let somebody else pick my side for me either, because that's not the way I play ball. I came to Houston because the Oilers had the bucks and laid them on me. You think it was love? Hell no. Money talks.
Alex pays us very well.
Sure. And we work in a real nice place. But it's only a place, Terry, not a life. Top of the world's just a place to stop along the way to better places. Places where you give the orders and somebody else takes them. And sooner or later, Terry, that's the place I'm going to be.
Then you do know something you're not telling Alex and Ryan, don't you?
Nah, I don't know anything. Come on, honey, I was just talking, just thinking out loud.
Clipper, do you swear? Do you swear that's all it was?
Sure. Hey, see if that champagne is still in there, would you?
Why?
Because I think we could both use a little something to loosen us up. I mean, we're both talking crazy, you know? Where's Alex? He's still out?
For the day, at least.
Well, then here's what we do. We take the afternoon off, go swimming at the apartment, waste the rest of the day and this bottle, and have an early supper, and then...
Clipper, I'd love to. You know I would, but I can't.
But you're always telling me how we never have enough time together.
I know, but... I have to wait for a call from Alex. He may be gone several days, and I have to get people to cover for him.
Don't look at me, then, if you want to know how come we don't see much of each other anymore. I mean, you're the one with other priorities.
Oh, come on, darling. Alex depends on me.
Sure. But does he love you like I do?
Can I depend on that?
You think you can?
Clipper Curtis.
Terry Decker.
I love you.
Me too. Now get.
Get?
Hey, if you don't want to go play, then I'm going back to work. And I got lots of work to do, so get. Yasmin, when this counterattack comes, where will you be?
Ryan, I'll go to the desert, to the mountains with my people. You know them. They would protect me with their lives. They'd never let anyone hurt me or harm me. Let's talk about something else, okay? How's everyone in Texas? How are my friends? How's Don?
Don, she lost her father, Yasmin.
What? Uncle Mike is dead? Ryan, what happened? He wasn't ill when I left.
No, he wasn't ill, but,
Well, what was it? Was it an accident? Are you there?
Yes.
What is it? What happened that you don't want me to know?
Mike, he committed suicide, Yasmin.
He shot himself a few nights after your father died.
Oh, God. Now, Don feels the same as I do. The fate of the children are tied to the fate of their fathers. We're all ruined. Our fortune and our futures. Ryan, please tell Don how sorry I am. And the others, too. Will you do that for me?
I will.
And find the men who murdered my father. For Don's sake as well as mine. Then return to Tancarin to me.
I will. In the meantime, I want you to make arrangements with the American consulate. I mean, in case things go bad.
My people will protect me.
I just don't want you taking any unnecessary chances. You hear me?
I know, I hear you. Ryan! I'll be here waiting for you when you return.
I'm sorry, but there's been a malfunction in the satellite transfer. If you'll wait just a moment, sir, I can have you reconnected.
No, no, operator, that's all right. We've said everything there is to say, for now.
You know, Don, I'm glad you stayed out here. At first, I couldn't go back to the house in town because of Daddy. And now I can't go back because they're going to sell it. Not just the house, everything.
Yeah, I know.
I'm glad you came. I don't think I could have come back into Houston. When I'm here with Grandma and Ginny and Steve, I can almost pretend none of it's happened. Until I try to go to sleep. And I hear the shot. And I run into the study.
Gotta look ahead now, Dawn.
I know. I don't dare look back, do I?
You don't have to look back. You know, only one life ended that night. And it wasn't yours.
No, that's not so, Dennis. You can't even imagine how much ended that night. We had a family. Well, some of us were scattered all over, but it was still a family. Now, we're just a bunch of people who know each other very, very well.
No, you can't let it come to that. You know, that's not what Mike would have wanted.
Well, that's what he left us.
You don't mean that. You don't mean that.
No, of course I don't. But that's how I feel. Like an orphan. Grandma wants us to come back here. She says it's where we belong. I know Jenny feels the same way, but...
What?
I feel so ashamed for not wanting that. I know I should. If we all came here, this place could heal us. But I want to spread my wings. I want to fly. I want to paint. I want to learn.
And you can do that if it's what you want.
No. Because there's not going to be anything left. When they've sold everything, it will be as if they've erased all my life.
Look, even if they take away the past, you still have the present and the future. The ranch is here, the land, the trees. Look, water running freely, new life everywhere. And this is the summer of our lives, Dawn. Look.
Take them to Daddy's grave.
No. If you want some more for that, I'll get them. But these are for you. For the living. Do you know how much I want you to be happy?
No. Tell me.
You're young. And you're beautiful. And your whole life is ahead of you. And I want that life to be as rich and full as it should be.
Dennis, I want to believe that. But I keep feeling pulled backward by what's happened. It's as if my whole life will always be headed towards something wonderful, something I want so much. And suddenly I'll find myself in that hallway. And I'll hear that shot again. And I'll find myself running into the study, and I can't...
We're gonna close that door. Forever.
I can't. I can't turn away from my father.
Well, that's not what it is. He's not there anymore. He's free. No more pain, and no more confusion. And Dawn, now we've got it for you too. Because I love you so very much.
And I need you. I need your strength.
I know. How much I've missed you. Even a couple of days. Dawn, I want to be with you forever. And I don't ever want us to be apart again.
Welcome to the Iris, ma'am.
The Iris?
That's right. This ship is Mr. Wheeler's pride and joy. He had it rechristened after he bought it.
Well, it's lovely, but...
Yes?
Just that I feel as if this isn't the first time I've walked along this deck.
Perhaps you've been aboard before. The Iris has been around a while.
Oh?
Years ago, when Mr. Wheeler first hired me, I was a captain without a ship. And I stayed that way quite a while. I had to look all over Europe for this particular ship. Mr. Wheeler wouldn't have any other.
He wouldn't? Where did you find the Iris?
The places she'd been before I found her. Logorno, Trieste, some of the Greek islands. But I found her in Saint-Tropez. Then she had to be reconditioned. And when that was done, we sailed her back to Texas. And here she is, as lovely, as strong as she was 25 years ago. The Iris means a lot to Mr. Wheeler. Though I've never been sure exactly why. Well, if you'll excuse me, Mr. Wheeler will join you shortly.
The same ship. I know it is.
Miss Quarry, that young man says he knows you. Shall I ask him to come in?
But I don't believe I remember him.
Hi there, pretty lady. I'm Alex Wheeler of Texas, and you, of course, are unforgettable.
Hello, pretty lady.
You're Alex Wheeler.
Have I changed so much?
No, not that much. I still see him. Yes, I think he's still there.
He?
The boy I knew a long time ago. Have I changed?
No. Not at all. You're as beautiful as ever. More beautiful. When I saw you at the opera, when I looked up, you were there. I thought my heart would stop. I thought, being controlled by my dreams, what I've been dreaming for every day of my life for 25 years.
Was it that long ago? Yes. that long since you walked into my life and out again?
Iris, my darling.
You called me that then and afterward.
Could you believe I wanted to leave? That day I walked out of that small hotel in Saint-Tropez. I was exiled from my future, from the only love I could ever want. Ryan said he told you.
About the young Boston sailor who pretended to be a rich Texan. Yes, he told me.
No.
It seems the transformation is complete. The sailor boy is that rich Texan he wanted so much to be.
You don't understand. I never cared about that. Till I met you. Till I saw you on this yacht and seeing you.
Seeing me?
Of course. How could I say, I'm Alex Wheeler from Boston. I have nothing but hopes, nothing to give of myself. Will you spend the rest of your life with me? No, I couldn't do that. I knew I'd lose you. And you were a vision. The dream that every man supposes he'll find someday. I wasn't ready yet. I couldn't take that chance. I had to lie.
And what else did you pretend?
Nothing. Nothing at all. Can you believe I lied when I told you I loved you? That you were the only thing that mattered to me in life?
No, I never doubted then. But afterward...
The way I felt then is the way I feel now. Everything I did was because of you. Because of us. Even my pretenses have come true. Today I can say, hello, pretty lady. I'm Alex Wheeler from Texas. It's true. Everything I've ever wanted. All I want is you.
Oh, Alex. So many years. So much pain you can't even know of. How can either of us feel the same? The world isn't that way.
No one
allows us.
No one knows more about the world than I do. Allows whatever that we're strong enough and we're brave enough to do. This yacht, this place where we first met.
I know, I recognized it.
We can repeal the years, take away those times when we were away from one another, say it never existed. This is what we were when we loved each other so much. And down below in the cabin is that breakfast we never had. Please. Come with me, my darling. Now is our time. This time belongs to us.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Texas.